sack?
That's it. I called court.
Didn't I?
Pay up.
Think I ain't it's watching. That's your fifth flu just of this round.
What of it?
Yeah, what of it?
Vara. She ain't coming.
Ah, grab it in your gobblers, the both of you.
Send us your children.
If you don't like the game, Topsy, you can fold.
Divine.
No, no. Just because the pair of you are filthy, cheating liars don't mean I can't beat you. What of it? Ah, grab it in your gobblers, the both of you!
If you don't like the
The
game,
woman is scrabbling at her throat, as though she can hardly breathe.
No, no. Just because the pair of you are filthy cheap.
Don't touch me! You're too close. This collar, this place, it's squeezing the life from me. Do you? You seem fine. Don't you feel how tight this collar is? And there's nothing we can do. Nothing we can do.
Her hands move again to her throat. She seems to try to make space between her neck and the collar, but there's no space to be made.
But why?
The woman is scrabbling at her throat, as though she can hardly breathe. As she catches sight of you, recognition flashes in her terrified eyes. She drops her hands from her throat and starts hyperventilating.
Ben Mest! Ivan! Ben Mest! You killed them! You killed them! He killed them all! Murderer! Keep him away from me! Help! Somebody! Keep him away!
A little respect for Griff's right hand, Topsy girl.
Guards! Guards! Keep him away from me! Stay back. Stay back. Keep that monster Ben Mest away from me.
Ha! Collared like a dog. A very tall, very strange smelling dog. I'd pity you, but Jack Crowley and Ethelbald has a soft spot for beauty, and you carry that tugger off so very well. laughing in the faces of my enemies, of course. Little do they know, the most powerful sorcerer the world has ever known scuttles on their very shores. This power is my birthright, same as yours, but one of us has grown to astounding heights and the other has sunk into depths too humiliating to describe. Pity. But of course, they'll happily dump your meager bony corpse into the sea when they're through with you. Oh, the tragedy of it. Ha! Of course, precious. But which is worse, the cure of a disease? Sorcerers dance while magisters pull the strings. Fools all! Their tomfoolery won't save them from the destruction the void shall wreak upon them.
Come on, you stubborn hunk of garbage.
The dwarf's fingers clamp around a splintered chunk of wood nailed to the skeleton of an old ship. His whole body strains with the effort of wrenching the plank free, to no avail.
Ah. Got two of my own, haven't I?
The dwarf spits into each of his calloused palms and rubs them together before placing them both back on the plank and pulling.
Must be charmed or something. Go on then, give it a go.
You grab the plank and pull. The rusted nail pops loose, and the plank promptly crumbles to pieces in your hand.
Oh, look at that. Nice of you to finish the job after I loosened her up.
You get a good look at the hearty fellow, broad as a hull and sunburnt from all sides. His beard is a cascade of meticulous plaits, each one braided through with golden medallions. He winks and flips a gold coin toward you. It makes a long, high arc, glinting in the sun, and lands squarely in your hand.
For your trouble. I suppose it were a fool's errand thinking I could make something out of this heap, but I couldn't help myself from trying.
He sucks a finger and holds it up to the wind, testing the breeze.
Winds like these, she would have capsized before she reached the break. Well, on to plan B.
He gives you a wry look, as though deciding whether to trust you.
Aye, was planning to build me a raft and paddle off. I've got business north of here, in a town called Driftwood. Far be it from me to miss an appointment. Why don't we make a deal then? You help me get out of this place, and I'll do the same for you. That's the spirit.
He lifts an invisible cap and bows with the grace of a courtier.
Pleased to make your acquaintance. The name's... well, the name's dead and buried. What matters is what they call me. Beast. May have been cast out, but you can bet your last heel of breed she wishes she hadn't of. I've taken my revenge a thousandfold on that tyrant's fleet. I'll tell you when you're older. Anyhow, we're a team now, so the me is not half as important as the us. Let's get down to brass tacks. Fighting, I mean. I've been up and down the realm so often it'd make your cabbage spin, and I picked up a few tricks along the way. Truth be told, I've grown fond of crushing and casting. A battle mage, if you like. But there's not so important as team dynamics. So what'll it be? Then it's settled. Capital. Aye. But it seems you've no room for old beast in your clan now. You come find me when a spot opens up, and take it from me. They say he likes it thick and long. And combs it out all dilly-eye day. He say he likes it big and strong. And combs it out all dilly-eye day. He twists and rubs and tweaks the nubs. He strokes and pokes like all the blokes. He say he'll touch it all day long. And combs it out all dilly-eye day.
Deplorable surrounding for an agreeable...
Are you certain you want to dismiss your companion?
Your loss.
Say he likes it thick and long. Let's team up, you and me. What do you say?
How do, partner?
Right now, though. Well, that's that.
I found you, didn't I? Red, they said. Red, then dead. Them that pay the bills, of course. I'll be a rich man when you're 6 feet under. Time's up, Your Highness. Let's dance.
should be happy for Greed.
It's stabbing time!
Yield to none.
Thank you. shelf.
Damned nuisance these assassins are. It's their frightful manners I mind the most, really.
Patience, Mal.
The woman looks out on the gently lapping waves. She seems totally at peace, but as you approach, she turns to you with a cheerful smile.
Patience, Mal. Patience. Patience.
Haven't seen you around here before. New? Well, Don't worry too much if you have a hard time settling in. Takes a while to get used to the place. You here alone?
She gives you a long look.
You keep them friends of yours close, eh? Some of us haven't got anyone at all anymore. Not much in this world someone you love can't make better. It's nothing. If I haven't learnt that by now, I haven't learnt anything at all.
Here you are. I wonder what keeps you. Tell me your tale. You are back, so you are ready. You are ready to tell me your tale, and you tell me now.
Thank you.
Start from the beginning. Start from where you come. I see. Now tell me more. Tell me what you do. Tell me, what do you find? I understand. Now tell me how your story ends. Ah, you want reunion. Life is lonesome, yes, life is lonesome. The thing you love is gone. I have something for you, my friend. A gift. We can see the things we lose, not with our eyes, but with our hearts. This ruby does the trick. It is nothing. Many fragments swirl on my shore. See what I gather. Tides in and out and in again. Tides in and out and in again. Patience, Mal. Patience. Cowrie, cockle, clam.